Hi friends, in this video I'm going to talk about what Zomato IPO means for retail investors. I have written multiple blogs about IPOs and also the dynamics that goes behind IPOs in my previous episodes. Keeping that aside, what I wanted to talk in this video is primarily whether it's worth investing in Zomato IPO or not. My answer to that is probably not. Here are some reasons that I want to list down why the Zomato IPO might not be the best choice for retail investors. Number one, usually when the IPOs are created by the merchant bankers or the so-called investment bankers, they usually price it at a premium to their actual intrinsic value or what it's actually worth. So the moment the IPO hits the secondary markets, which is on the listing day, the stocks usually will be overvalued, right? So what it means for the investment bankers or merchant bankers, you might ask. The merchant banker who's responsible for the listing of this Zomato IPO, his incentive is directly related to the success of the IPO, right? So the more higher the cost it lists, the higher the bonus or commission that he takes away from the IPO listing. And the second reason is that the existing investors, right, it can be Naukri or it can be other venture capital firms or other private equity firms, they were early investors in this company. So now two questions that come to our mind is, if the company is prospective and has huge growth opportunities in the coming years, why do they want to exit? Because the answer is simple, due to the fact that these investors, they have already captured the prime growth years of this company, which means that in the coming years, the growth might not be as exponential as we have seen in the past, right? So where they wanted to now cash out all the profits that they made, so where they are now looking for the opportune time. Look at the metrics around you. Sensex, Nifty, touching all-time high. Most of the large cap, mid cap and small cap stocks are also hitting all-time highs. Now there are a lot of millennial retail investors who got into the stock market for the first time. They started trading in stocks which they have not researched, and last 1 year has been completely positive for everyone. So any stock that you buy randomly, you would have made money, right? So historically, if you have seen this kind of phenomenon, it has rarely occurred where this kind of phenomenon has continued for a very long period of time. So now when the market is flush with a lot of liquidity, these promoters, they wanted to exit during this opportune time. Now this is the opportune time for them to exit, right? So last March, market went down, but we didn't see Zomato or Paytm IPO that were about to be launched. Why? Because the promoters know for the fact that the valuation they will get might not be attractive, right? And the third important reason is the company is not profitable, right? Look at the sales and profits of this company. The company is not profitable. So when the company is not making any profit, the promoters might try something, but the retail investors might not make some money. So keeping these three reasons in mind, you should actually stay away from IPOs. And there are 7,000 odd companies that are trading in stock markets, and there are n number of ways to go to Rome, and this is not the way to go to Rome. So I would recommend you to stay away from different IPOs, and I hope you are able to protect your capital and grow and compound it over a long period of time. So I hope you find this video useful, and feel free to subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. Thank you so much.